So in the beginning, before wanting to compete, I kind of thought like I had to be this confident, strong-minded, I guess empowered person before I was like able to compete. I thought I had to be this person before and to be, you know, strong and everything like that. But it's like, that's what took me so long to not do it, because I didn't think I was any of those, had any of those qualities that it took to compete. But it's actually through the whole journey itself, through competing, that I've grown to become this person. So I feel like if anyone's like wanting to do something but they don't feel that they're there ready, good enough to do it, or they don't see themselves as that person or that role, and it's that fear that's stopping them from doing it, I definitely recommend just doing it anyway, because it's through that journey of that growth that you become who you want to become. And yeah, so definitely don't hold back from your dreams, and if you don't feel like you're there, just take that leap of faith and you'll grow along the way, and it is definitely 100% worth it. It's definitely worth that little bit of unsureness and uncomfortableness in the beginning. Yeah, it's just worth everything. So definitely go for your dreams, and yeah, take that leap of faith.
And so the question is, what do you believe? Do you believe that you are worthy of happiness?
I know that if you allow the past to define your present, that you never actually really get to live the life that you're meant to live.
You are responsible for your life. And if you're sitting around waiting on somebody to save you, to fix you, to even help you, you are wasting your time, because only you have the power to take responsibility to move your life forward.
What does perfect even mean? Is there even such a thing? Can we switch up all the rules and imagine a utopia? Honey, I'm a perfect 10. Whoa, whoa. Honey, I'm a perfect 10. Whoa, whoa.
So back in the gym today, Monday. Back training, back to my normal schedule. I got an amazing refeed on Saturday night with all my friends and family, my partner. It was super awesome. The weekend was absolutely incredible. So my first time competing with ICN, was an absolute dream come true. So I entered into three categories. So it was bikini novice, bikini rookie, and then also bikini open. And I won my three categories, which I was super, it was absolutely incredible and amazing. And which put me into the overalls. And I won the overalls as well. So, bikini overalls champion. So now I get the opportunity to go to Sydney to represent WA for nationals. Oh my God, I'm super excited. I cannot wait. This is like an absolute dream come true. I've been working towards this like well over 10 years now, and to achieve it in my first season is absolutely phenomenal. Just all the support I've had through like my coach and my partner and my family and friends and all the other girls as well along the way, along the journey, it's just been absolutely incredible. I cannot wait, I'm super excited. So I have 4 weeks. 4 weeks to smash out some more workouts, keep up with my nutrition and my cardio and everything like that, work on my posing, so here we go, Sydney. So here we are at Perth Airport on our way to Sydney, just hanging around waiting for our plane, just hanging out with everyone. We're all super excited and can't wait to get to Sydney and catch the plane. So I've got coming with me, I've got my partner Dion, he's the one harassing me with the camera, and also my coach Michelle, she's flying over with us as well, so got some amazing support. So we took a red eye to Sydney. We arrived about 6 a.m. Have not slept yet. Definitely feeling tired and fatigued. Our hotel wasn't ready yet, so we just stayed in Sam's room, all of us together, and just waiting for our check-in, which was about 2 o'clock. So just went to the shops, picked up a few supplies. We've got Gatorade, just a few bits and pieces of food. Waiting for our hotel to be ready. Now we're making our way to our room because it is ready. So we stayed in room 407 and just unpacked our suitcase and getting everything sorted. I was feeling a little bit tight and having a bit of cramping and stuff, so just having some Gatorade for some electrolytes and doing a bit of foam rolling. And Michelle gave me some magnesium tablets just to help with muscle cramping.
Yeah, I called my friend.
Ready to go?
I'm the local drug dealer.
What drug are you over here?
Come see me. I've got
the drug dealer.
All the goodies.
Magnesium.
That'll be $100.
Just resting. Still haven't had any sleep at this point. Then we made our way over to do some posing. So just some last minute posing with everybody. That was pretty cool. We got to do it all together. Just have a little bit of a play around with everything. And ready for the next day.
Let's go. I'ma make a couple stacks, do exactly what I want to. Mix a couple tracks, get a lady that I'm drawn to. Turn up to the max, get me faded till I'm gone, dude. I do what I want, couldn't stop me if you wanted to. I just work hard,
So the best thing about going to Sydney Nationals was definitely the ICN team. Just being around the same like-minded people, everyone supporting everyone, and it was just incredible. Like, I've never been around a more like-minded team, and I've never felt more like I've belonged, and everyone was all on the same level. Like, we were all just laughing and talking about competing, talking about the pros and cons of prep. And competing can definitely be a very isolating sport. And it's just really cool just being around other people that have experienced and are going through the same thing. So we bond on so many levels. And we're all just really chilled, relaxed people. And it's just, it's cool just being around everyone and supporting each other and listening about all our journeys. And we're all there for growth. And it's just amazing. So wake up 4 a.m. wake up time, tan hair and makeup, and then on stage about 7:30 in the morning, so showtime.
So the mums flew over from Perth just for the day to see Crystal compete.
And
here we go.
And we're flying straight back.
We haven't been to bed yet.
No.
Stay up all day.
Yeah.
Surprise her. Get to see her compete.
Super excited.
She's going to do really well. As you can imagine, you've got the best of the best coming from all over the country, from almost every state, those who are able to get to Sydney, obviously. But you never know what can happen on the day. You can never say with certainty how it's going to go, but I expect big things from Crystal. I'm very excited, and I know she is, and many other people are as well. I cannot wait to see her up on that stage. Is Crystal ready to be on stage with the best of the best? Without a doubt. She's earned a place there. She's going to stand there, centre stage, proud. Definitely deserves it, and I can't wait to see that.
So the aim of Nationals was to get my pro card. So that means you can compete on a international level. So versing all the other different countries and stuff, which would be amazing. I'm definitely extremely proud of myself for, on the day, everything that I did. I did everything possible to for my presence and my stage presence and my posing. And I'm just super proud of the package that I bought. Every comp that I did, it just kept getting better and better, and I definitely grew along the way. And I couldn't have been prouder of myself for my achievements and everything that I did. It was just an amazing experience all around. So in order to get a pro card, you have to win an open category or take out bikini overalls. So that's versing all the other different states. And yeah, so that's just how you get your pro card. Yeah, it just leaves me the opportunity to go for it again. Yes, so I can't wait. And each year, they usually do it once a year, but we've got another one coming up for these seasons, so I might go for that, depending how I feel. But yeah, see if I can get a bit more growth in between now and then. If not, I'll look at it maybe next year.
Oh, it's changed dramatically. She's a completely different person than when she started, but a better person. It has made her more confident, it's made her believe in herself, it's made her see strength in herself but strength in others, and now she knows how she can uplift other women and make them have that same confidence in themselves as well.
I definitely got the outcome that I was after, just the mental growth. And you know, I used to feel very insecure within my body and unaware how to move it, and just always felt, I guess, quite like contained and trapped within my mind. And well, there's through competing, there's a lot of stuff that, you know, you just have to do in front of people, be vulnerable, and you know, it's kind of like do it or be uncomfortable. So it's through being uncomfortable that you become comfortable, I guess, like. Yeah, and I definitely don't feel as shy as I used to around people, and I just love meeting new people. Whereas before, I'd feel a bit, I guess, awkward around new people, a bit unsure of how they would, I guess, view me. Whereas now, like, when I meet a new person, I'm like, awesome, like, I'm excited to meet them and I feel comfortable. And yeah, it's just definitely shown how much I've grown along the way, and yeah, definitely lots of different areas as well. What does the future hold for me next? I definitely want to carry on competing. I feel like it is my sport, it is my passion. I feel like I belong, and I love having a goal and something to strive towards. And I just really massively want to help and encourage, you know, other women who face similar mental battles that I have faced. So if I can help and encourage them along the way, whichever way that'll be, through mentoring, through the gym, through just speaking to you guys, and giving you guys, I guess, little tips and tricks along the way. Yeah, just start there and see where it takes me.